Our certain hope in all of life's varied circumstances. We have come together within the strengthening fellowship of friends and family to praise God for the life of Ruth Marie Roberts. We gather to share our grief with God and with one another, to reaffirm our faith in God's unfailing goodness, and to hear again God's promise of resurrection.
Please join me in the spirit of prayer. Eternal and loving God, we praise you. We praise you for the great company of all those who have finished their course in faith and now rest from their labor. We praise you for those dear to us whom we name in our hearts before you. We especially praise you for Ruth, whom you have graciously received into your presence. To all of these, grant your peace. Let perpetual light shine upon them. And help us believe where we have not seen, that your presence may lead us through our years and bring us at last with them into the joy of your home, not made with hands, but eternal in the heavens. Just through Jesus Christ, our Lord, we pray. Amen. Now hear these holy words from 2 Corinthians. Therefore, we are always confident and know that as long as we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord. For we live by faith, not by sight. We are confident, I say, and would prefer to be away from the body and at home with the Lord. And these holy words from Psalm 90. Lord, you have been our dwelling place in all generations. Before the mountains were brought forth, or ever you had formed the earth and the world, from everlasting to everlasting, you are God. You turn us back to dust and say, turn back, you mortals. For 1,000 years in your sight are like yesterday when it is past, or like a watch in the night. You sweep them away. They are like a dream, like grass that is renewed in the morning. In the morning it flourishes and is renewed. In the evening it fades and withers. The days of our life are 70 years or perhaps 80, if we are strong. Even in their span is only toil and trouble. They are soon gone and we fly away, So teach us to count our days so that we may gain a wise heart. And finally, these words from Revelation. Each of the four living creatures had six wings and was covered with eyes all around, even under its wings. Day and night they never stopped saying, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come." Amen.
Diane, you weren't expecting this, were you? This is one of my favorite poems, and I think Ruth would like it. Titled, When I'm Gone. When I am gone, release me. I have so many things to see and do. You must not tie yourself with me with tears. Be happy that we had so many years. I gave you love. You can only guess how much you gave me in happiness. I thank you for the love each of you have shown. But now it's time I traveled alone. So grieve a while for me, if grieve you must. Then let your grief be comforted by but trust. It is only for a while that we must part, so bless those memories within your heart. I will not be far away, for life goes on. So if you need me, call and I will come. Though you cannot see or touch me, I will be near. And if you listen with all your heart, you will hear all of my love, soft and clear. Then when you must come this way alone, I will greet you with a smile and a welcome home.
I don't exactly remember my first face-to-face moment meeting Ruth Roberts, but I've always known who Ruth Roberts is. This is what I know to be true about Ruth. She was a member of our congregation. She was strong in opinion and in spirit. She volunteered in the hospital gift shop. She was proud that she was still driving. When she didn't call and update us on her life, there were other members of the congregation who would do so, and she talked on the phone often. What I did not know about Ruth, I learned from her friends. They described Ruth as a lady, a sweet lady, spunky, a friend. And I asked one of Ruth's friends from the church if he had any stories to share with me about Ruth. With a smile on his face, he said, "You can't hear any of those." So for those of you who know Ruth the best, I'm sure that you know those stories. You, her family, the ones that know her best, described her as the best. A flamboyant kind of gal, accepting, sharp, wonderful mom, great cat mom and dog mom, a people person, chatty. She was an all-American grandma, except for her cooking. She was a good sport and made sure to attend all the grandkids' band concerts and football games. Ruth, as I've gathered from her life and the things that you have shared with me, was alive. She maybe couldn't hear well toward the end, but she could remember, keep track of, and do all the things. She only had one fender bender in all of her years of driving, and that was just recently in the last couple of months. She was always willing to try new things, jet skiing, traveling, boating, and riding in John's go-kart. Whatever the family was doing or wanted to do was what Ruth was doing or wanted to do. She loved sports, especially the Iowa Hawkeyes, basketball and football, and she would call all the children and grandchildren to remind them when the games were on and what channels they could be found, whether they were interested in watching or not. She loved talking, in person and on the phone. She talked to her family, she talked to her family's in-laws, she talked to anyone walking by, and she talked with people working wherever she happened to be exercising or shopping that day. Ruth wore red lipstick, and when you couldn't avoid a kiss on the lips, she was leaving red kiss marks on your cheeks. She had an opinion, and she had no problem sharing that opinion. Once, after what I can only assume were many conversations, she sent money to Brad and John to encourage them to use it for a haircut and a shave. Not only will her family miss her, but so will the hospital gift shop, MCG, Walmart, and the Hy-Vee Pharmacy. I'm just not sure how those greeters will live their lives without Ruth's opinion on how they should do their job. And I'm sure those MCG guys will sure miss carrying in her groceries. Ruth Roberts was a people person. She was smart with an overwhelming and complicated life. She was smart with overwhelming and complicated life tasks, like anything having to do with insurance and paperwork. She was proud of her children, proud of her grandchildren. Ruth loved her husband Dick deeply, and had great companionship with Carl. Diane said, "It's so weird that she's gone." And I think weird is the perfect way to describe the absence of someone so filled with life. Someone so present in the lives of the family and friends that she loved so deeply. Someone who has been around for their entire lives and deeply central to the family. Ruth's presence and influence in this community, and especially with her family, reminds me of a scripture from John 14. Jesus was speaking to the people he loved the most, his disciples, and prepared them for his own death. I have to believe that the disciples were in shock, feeling the same sense of weirdness, scared, angry, and overwhelmed. So Jesus gave them these words of assurance. "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go and prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. If you love me, you will keep my commandments. And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you forever. This is the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive because it neither sees him nor knows him. But you know him, because he abides with you, and he will be in you." Jesus is reminding his disciples and reminding us that heaven, God's house, is filled with many dwelling places. And one of those places has been especially prepared for us. And God prepared a place for Ruth. She is not alone. She is with our loving Creator. And I believe with all those other dwelling places, she is having a fantastic reunion with all the people that loved her and have been loved by her that went to our God's house before us. And still, Jesus makes sure that you and we are not left in Ruth's absence. Jesus' commandments are familiar: to love the Lord your God with all your hearts and with all our minds and with all our strength, and love your neighbor as yourself. Jesus wasn't giving the disciples an ultimatum: if you really loved me, you would do this. That's not what was happening. Jesus was reassuring them: when you live this way, loving me, loving your neighbor, loving yourself, you will feel the Spirit of truth that God has given you. The fancy scholarly Greek name for this Spirit of truth is Paraclete. Translated from Greek, Paraclete means the one called alongside. When I read those words, "the one called alongside," I think of Ruth. I thought of the stories and the memories that you shared with me. The way Ruth was alongside you all through pageants and marriages and births and moves and adventures. The way she was alongside you with her phone calls and her advice giving. The way she was alongside you with her red lipstick and kisses. The way she was alongside you when you faced the worst days of your lives. The way she was alongside you when you really would have rather stayed at home or in bed. The way she is alongside you now, in this weirdness, in the emptiness, and in her absence through memories. Because of the way that Ruth kept Christ's commandments, she received the Spirit of truth. Because of the way Ruth kept Christ's commandments, she became the Spirit of truth. She became the one called alongside you. Not all of us can receive what you have, but because you know Ruth, you know Christ. Even now, gone from this world, they both abide with you. May that love and energy that describes Ruth be alongside you in these unbelievably difficult days. May the Paraclete, the Comforter, the Spirit of Truth given by God carry you in this hour and into the next. Amen.
Well, as we conclude the service, I'd like to invite you all to share a meal with the family at First Christian Church. And I would like to pray for that meal during this benediction. So please join me in prayer. Holy and loving God, may the hands that prepared the food be blessed. May the meal that we are about to share be blessed, and may our conversations bring light and life. And may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep our hearts and minds in the knowledge and the love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ. And the blessing of God Almighty be among us and remain with us always. Amen.
Some glad morning when this life is over, I'll fly away to a home on God's celestial shore.